हेलो
ओके okay.
सर,
तो माय स्क्रीन इज विजिबल टू एवरीवन।
मुझे
हाँ
किसी का
हाँ
भी ये
क्या
सर का
हुआ?
आवाज नहीं आ रहा है।
मैंने अभी कुछ बात ही नहीं किया, अभी आवाज आ रही है क्या?
हाँ सर,
यस सर, ही
साहब को आवाज नहीं आ रही मेरी? अच्छा
इज रीजॉइनिंग।
ओके। ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीवन। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर आई हैव टॉक अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ परमानेंट मैग्नेट, दैट इज अ स्टेपर मोटर। ओके, नाउ टुडे वी आर सपोज टू सी द प्रोग्रामिंग, एंड बिफोर वी स्टार्ट विद द प्रोग्रामिंग इवन आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू द टेबल इन विच इन व्हाट सीक्वेंस आई हैव टू एनर्जाइज द स्टेपर मोटर। ओके, आई नीड टू एनर्जाइज और आई हैव टू पास द सप्लाई, द करंट सप्लाई टू द पर्टिकुलर वाइंडिंग। ओके, सो आई विल जस्ट रिवाइज दैट थिंग सो दैट इट विल बी क्लियर। माय स्क्रीन इज विजिबल टू एवरीवन?
यस सर,
यस सर,
ओके ओके। नाउ व्हेन यू टॉक अबाउट दिस पर्टिकुलर फिगर, I have told you, now it depends upon you, how do you want to rotate your rotor. Okay, let me yes, it depends upon you, how do you want to rotate this, whether you have to rotate this rotor into the clockwise direction or you have to rotate this in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so in that way you will be able to write down two different programs in which you will be rotating the rotor in clockwise or the other program to rotate your rotor in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so in this I have explained you, when you want to rotate this one in the clockwise direction, then in that case your AD will be 1 1 and your BC will be 0 0. Okay, so this will be 0 0 and this will be 1 1. Okay, and similarly when you need to see this particular pole, here you have S and here you have N. Okay, now in other way, now if you want to rotate this into the anti-clockwise direction, then in that case this A and B will be 1 1 and this will be 0 0. Then you will be able to see this direction will be in this manner. Okay, then again you have to rotate in the anti-clockwise direction. Now here we need to understand, depending upon the requirement, how are we going to rotate the motor, how are we going to rotate the motor. Okay, now this also I have told you, when your BC is equals to 1 1, then exactly you get the opposite of this. If you see the pole in this particular figure, south pole and north pole, the direction of the permanent magnet, and in the below figure you will see the opposite direction because you have made this BC as 1 1. So it is a drastic change. So it is a change of 180 degree. It is a change of 180 degree. Okay. Now, but as far as four steps are concerned, I have already told you, whenever it is a four step, then in that case you have to understand this figure. Okay. Now here they have given us a sequence. If you want to rotate the rotor, irrespective of clockwise or anti-clockwise direction, these are the codes which are formed. These are the codes which are formed. Okay. So if you want to rotate in the particular clockwise direction, okay, your AD should be on, then your AB should be on, then your AD should be off, and then your AB should be off. Okay, then you will be able to see the rotor rotating in the clockwise direction in four steps. This is a four step sequence. This is a four step sequence. Okay, so already I have explained you this. Now we are going to see the programming related with this table. Now, related with this table. Now there are two different ways in which the programming can be written down. Okay, I want everyone to pay attention. In the first program, I will be showing you the with respect to this course 9, C, 6, and 3. In other program, I will be showing you with a different concept. And that concept is also very much logical. तो आपको वो जो दूसरा प्रोग्राम है ना उसमें आपको एक्चुअली लॉजिक भी समझ में आएगा कि क्या लॉजिक यूज किया है. यहाँ पे क्या लॉजिक यूज किया है, वी हैव फॉर्मुलेटेड द कोड्स एंड यू आर वी आर डायरेक्टली यूजिंग दिस कोड्स इन द प्रोग्राम डिपेंडिंग अपॉन क्लॉकवाइज चाहिए एंटी क्लॉकवाइज चाहिए. नाउ फॉर एग्जांपल इफ दिस कोड इज रिटन फॉर द क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन द कोड विल बी रिप्रेजेंटेड इन द गिवन सीक्वेंस. फॉर एग्जांपल अगर सबसे पहले मैं लिख रहा हूं सिक्स के बाद आने चाहिए कोड थ्री के बाद आने चाहिए कोड नाइन और नाइन के बाद कोड आना चाहिए सी. सो वॉट एवर द कोड नंबर यू आर टेकिंग फर्स्ट आफ्टर दैट द सीक्वेंस शुड बी फॉलोड इफ आई वॉन्ट टू रोटेट इन द क्लॉक वाइज डायरेक्शन. बट इफ आई वॉन्ट टू रोटेट इन द एंटी क्लॉक वाइज डायरेक्शन सपोज आई एम टेकिंग द कोड फर्स्ट एज सिक्स द नेक्स्ट टाइम द कोड विल बी टेकन एज सी देन द नेक्स्ट टाइम द कोड विल बी टेकन एज नाइन एंड देन द कोड विल बी टेकन एज थ्री. So this is for anti-clockwise direction. This is for the anti-clockwise direction. Okay. Now the important thing is once you have the code, how do you represent the code in the given sequence in the program? That is more important. So depending upon whether you want to rotate the rotor or the stepper motor in the clockwise direction, you take any of the code out of the four as the first code and follow the sequence. If you want to follow, if I'm taking six as the first sequence, and in the clockwise direction 3 will be followed, 9 will be followed, C will be followed. So this is how it should be followed. If I am taking 6 as the first code and if I want to rotate the rotor in the anti-clockwise direction, then 6 should be followed by C, then 9 and then 3. So this is how it should be followed. Okay, now this is one way when you have four codes with you. Then there is the other way. So वो next वाला जो program है with the other logic that thing I will explain you once you complete this particular programming by using the logic which I have shown you just now. Have you understood this now till now? Any problem you have in this?
No, no sir.
Okay, now this is important. Now after this we will be able to see now the program. Now directly we will jump to the program. So always remember before you start with the program, you should know the algorithm. But here I will directly switch to the program. Program samajh mein aaya, so you will be able to know the algorithm also. So the program is here now. Yes, this is the program. Now before I go to the program, let me show you the configuration. Let me tell you the how the circuit will be connected. Now this is a figure in detail. But before I come to this figure, there is a smaller figure which is a replica of this particular figure. But the figure which I have shown you just now, that is in detail, you can have this figure also. Yes, this figure. Okay, now I want everyone to pay attention. This is important. Now this is your interfacing. Now here you have 8051. Here you have stepper motor. And in between this is important one. Now this is called as driver circuit to drive your stepper motor. Okay, so this is your 8051. This is your driver circuit. And this is your stepper motor. So I cannot connect my stepper motor with the 8051 directly. It has to be through the driver. The only reason is that your 8051 is a low power. It's a low power device. That means whatever the current which will be given at the ports, port P1.0, P1.1, P1.2, and P1.3, the current is very less. And to drive my stepper motor. Or in that case, if I want to give the current to the windings, to energize these windings, the current supply required will be more. Okay. So to boost the current, I would require the driver circuit. I would require the driver circuit. Okay. Now here the specific driver IC is ULN 2003. So this is the most widely used the component or the driver which will give you the current specific the stepper motor. आप जब stepper motor का जब manual देखेंगे उस manual में दिया रहता है कि what should be the current capacity or what should be the current given to the winding. So depending upon that, I will be using the driver, sir. I will be using the driver, sir. Okay. So this ULN will give me the sufficient current which will be given to winding A, winding B, winding C, and winding D. Okay. So these are the driver circuit. Now in this driver circuit, you also have the diodes. You also have the diodes. So these are the diodes which will actually the transistors which will give me the specific current to drive my stepper motor. Okay, to drive my stepper motor. Now these diodes, these diodes are not used to give you the sufficient current, but these there are transistors present in the ULN 2003. You actually have diodes and you actually have transistors. Okay, so there are four transistors and there are four diodes. So in this figure you will be able to see these diodes. So diode ka function alag hai, transistor ka function hai to give you the sufficient to give you the specific current to drive your stepper motor. Now what is the function of the diode? These diodes are called as a freewheeling diode. Okay, these diodes are called as freewheeling diode. Freewheeling diode. Now ye diode ka kya function hai? This diode will not reverse bias your transistors. Now whenever it happens that the current flow is more, it will not reverse bias your transistors. So they are called as a freewheeling diodes. They are called as a freewheeling diode. So freewheeling diode ka yahi kaam hai to do not allow your transistors to be reverse biased. Because when transistors are forward biased, it is giving you the specific value of current. Okay. Now these current can be reversed back to make the transistors as in the reverse bias to avoid that more amount of current to reverse back your transistors. Your diodes are used. So they are called as a freewheeling diodes. The transistors are used. Okay. Even these freewheeling diodes we'll be seeing when we study the relay. जब हम रिले भी पढ़ने वाले और उसका इंटरफेसिंग जब देखेंगे तो फ्री वैलिंग डायोड्स मैं वहां पे भी बताऊंगा. ओके, सो ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट ULN 2003 इज अ ड्राइवर सर्किट व्हिच विल प्रोवाइड द सफिशिएंट करंट टू ड्राइव योर स्टेपर मोटर एंड ULN कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ टू इंपॉर्टेंट कंपोनेंट्स. वन इज डायोड एंड अदर इज अ ट्रांजिस्टर. डायोड्स आर फोर, ट्रांजिस्टर्स आल्सो फोर. ओके, द ट्रांजिस्टर्स विल गिव यू द सफिशिएंट करंट आई एन फ्री एंड दीज डायोड्स आर कॉल्ड एज अ फ्रीव्हीलिंग डायोड to avoid the transistors to go into the reverse bias. Okay, and this is the how the connections are made. Okay, now here you will be also able to see there are four registers, 47k, this is also 47k, this is also 47k, this is also 47k. Can any one of you tell me why these registers are connected? Any one of you?
Sir, pull up resistors.
पुल अप रजिस्टर और दूसरा क्या रीजन?
वोल्ट वन में तो होता होगा पुल अप सर. वोल्टेज डिवाइडर सर, वोल्टेज डिवाइडर.
मुझे पहले ये बात बताओ कि पुल अप रजिस्टर हम कहाँ पे यूज करते हैं?
सर पोर्ट जीरो में यूज करते हैं.
आर यू श्योर? अदर्स प्लीज चेक वेदर आर वी यूजिंग द पुल अप रजिस्टर इन पोर्ट जीरो, पोर्ट वन, पोर्ट टू और पोर्ट थ्री. गो बैक टू योर प्रीवियस पेजेस एंड लेट मी नो. Are we using pull-up resistors in which ports? Whether it is port 0, port 1, port 2 and port 3. ठीक है, वो चेक करके मुझे बताओ. Now here the important thing is that we are providing plus 5 volt at this point and at this point. So your power supply will be given to the stepper motor, your power supply will be given to the driver circuit and your power supply will be given to this particular resistors. okay? So these are the three power supplies of plus 5 volt and plus 5 volt, okay? And this is how the circuit is made. This is called as an interfacing circuit. You cannot connect 8051 connect directly with the stepper motor. Now this particular figure is explained in detail with the other circuit diagram. Now this is actually called as a block diagram, but you have a specific circuit diagram, and the circuit diagram is
sir
the one. हाँ बताओ
सर एक डाउट है सर पोर्ट एक सर वो पोर्ट जीरो में यूज होता है पुल अप रेजिस्टर्स
सो पुल अप रेजिस्टर्स आर यूज्ड इन
पोर्ट जीरो सर
हाँ
और बाकी सब में इंटरनल पुल अप रेजिस्टर्स होते हैं
हाँ तो यहाँ पे आपका ये जो रजिस्टर्स है वो पोर्ट वन को यूज किया है श्योर बराबर है
हाँ सर
सो एक्चुअली सो देयर शुड बी अ पोर्ट जीरो देन So this is wrong. So this port should be port 0, port 0.0. This is port 0.1, and this is port 0.2, and this is port 0.3. If you want to use the pull-up resistors, then you have to use port 0. If I don't want to use port 0, then you need not use pull-up resistors. That is, then directly it should be P1. Other than port 0, you can take other ports, P1, P2, and P3. Okay? So, here correction is there. Here you have a correction.
Okay. Sir, मुझे दो questions हैं.
हाँ.
Sir, पहले तो, sir, लेकिन हम लोग तो sir 10 किलो ओम का resistor connect करते हैं ना port 0 से for VCC. मतलब sir, अगर standard VCC 5 volts लेंगे, तो sir, उसके लिए 10 किलो ओम का resistor.
No, 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 no. It all depends upon how much current supply has to be given to this stepper motor. Depending upon that, will be, now it is a designing, this is a designing problem. This is a designing problem that what resistance value should be connected. It depends upon how much input current has to be given to the diode or the transistors to the driver circuit and how much current we require at the output. Depending upon that, the value of the pull-up resistors will change. Okay, now this is a designing problem. There is a 47K connected because of the designing or design in such a manner that the output of this particular driver circuit should drive my stepper motor. If it is not giving you the sufficient current, this value of pull-up resistor will change. This value of pull-up resistor will change. Okay. And designing ka hamare we don't have the, this is not the part of the syllabus to have a designing concept, but try to understand it all depends upon how much current you want to drive the stepper motor. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Sir, एक और doubt है.
हाँ,
sir, हमने वो inverter क्यों use किया मतलब उसमें?
This is not an inverter. This should be a diode. मैं आपको आगे बताता हूँ. This is a diode.
Oh, okay.
These are all diodes. These are not inverters. These are all diodes. Okay. So I will show you the. हाँ, मैं आपको बताता हूँ इसका circuit diagram. This is just to explain to the block diagram that there has to be a driver circuit in between stepper motor and 805. Now we will see. Yes, this is a circuit. Now here, this is your port. Now here they have used port 2, port 2.3. Okay. Now here also you can see there are resistors connected. Then Now, if I'm using my port 0, then you have to use the pull-up resistor. Okay. Now, if I'm using other than this port 0, actually these resistors which are used, this is also the resistor which is a current limiting resistor. Okay. Now, you try to understand if I'm not using port 0, you better use port 1, say like a port 2 or port 3 in any of these three ports. Even you have to connect your particular register value. Now register value is a designing problem. So these registers are not, it is also functions as a pull up register and current limiting registers. Okay, so as I have told you that if I'm using port 0, you are using the pull up registers, but other than port 0, if I'm using other ports also, P1, P2, P3, then also the registers are used. Now these registers are also the same registers which are as a pull up register, because aapko pata hai P1, P2, P3 ke paas bhi uska internal pull up register hota hai. But if I want to, it is all designing aspect ki hum transistor kaun sa laga rahe, hum diode kaun sa connect kar rahe, and how much current I require for the stepper motor. Depending upon that, if required, there is a external register has to be connected if I'm using P1, P2 and P3, because you know P1, P2, P3, they have internal register, pull up register. Lekin agar lagta hai as per the design, then we can have additional registers connected. Please remember this. This is also the current limiting register. Now I hope this is clear now. Okay, so even though P0 is used, but lekin kaisa hai, agar PO dikhate to mujhe pull up register bhi dikhana padega P0 ka, aur mujhe ye external registers bhi dikhane padega. So that's why what they have done, other than P0, they have taken other ports, P1, P2 and P3. They have shown that they have internal registers, but external registers also has to be connected as per the requirement, depending upon how much current you have to drive. Okay, so this is VCC with the pull up registers, you can say, or externally connected registers. Okay, then you have transistors T1, T2, T3. So I have told you four transistors are there, and irrespective four diodes as per the connected with the transistor. So these diodes are called as a freewheeling diode, which will not reverse bias your respective transistor T1, T2, T3, T4. Okay, and then this will be energized. Okay, and these windings will be given to the stepper motor to rotate your motor. Okay, now this is a circuit diagram, okay, in detail to tell you about how the connections has to be made. Okay, and the previous one was the block diagram. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes sir.
Okay. Now we will go to the program. Now I want everyone to pay attention. Programming is important. Now here you have a program. See ORG 0005. Okay, now you know the sequence. I have taken the first code as 03. Okay. Okay. So 03 is followed by, now I cannot take 3 as it, because your port is of 8 bit. Remember, 3 nahi le sakta main, I have to take 03. So I have taken 03, so it becomes 8 bit. Okay. Then I should take not 9, I should take 09. Then comes 0C and then comes 06. This is how it should be followed. Now this is for clockwise direction. Okay, this is for clockwise direction. If I want to convert into anti-clockwise direction, the programming will be slight change. Now you will see one by one. Now move P2, because as per the circuit diagram, I am taking port 2. Okay, so port 2 mein main pehle 03 move karunga. So load step sequence 03. Then A call delay. I am calling the delay. Okay, I will tell you why we have to call to the delay. Then again you have to move 09. Again you have to call delay. Again, you have to move 0C. Again, you have to call delay. Again, you have to move 06. And again, you have to call delay. Now, if I want to continuously move the stepper motor, then you have to jump to the loop. So, AJMP, absolute jump to the loop. And this will continue. Okay. And this is the delay now. This is a delay program. Okay. So, this is simple. You load the value into 05. Then there is a delay one. You load FF into 07. Okay. Then S1 DJNZ R7 S1. Jump karte raho jab tak aapka R7 0 nahi hota hai. Then once it is 0, then again you have to be in the same thing when your R5 becomes 0. Then you have to return back. Okay. This is not through the interrupt. This is through the program itself. So it is RET and end the program. So as simple as it is. Can anyone of you tell me why there should be a delay?
सर बिकॉज वो रोटेट करेगा पहले,
हाँ
उसके बाद उससे वो कमांड मिलना चाहिए आगे जाने का मतलब. सर
नो, यस एनीवन थिंक ओवर दिस एंड लेट मी नो फास्ट. हम पहले 03 भेज रहे, डिले कर रहे, बाद में हम 09 कर रहे, डिले कर रहे, 06 भेज रहे, डिले कर रहे, 06 भेज रहे, डिले कर रहे. Now this is in clockwise direction. You have this motor, rotor. पहले ऐसा, बाद में ऐसा. Okay. So I think the initially it should start with this. Suppose पहले ऐसा होगा. पहले rotor ऐसा रहेगा, बाद में rotor ऐसा होगा, बाद में rotor ऐसा जाएगा, और बाद में rotor ऐसा जाएगा. So this is first step. This is second. बाद में third. बाद में fourth. और फोर के बाद अगेन यू कम बैक टू द फर्स्ट स्टेप. कैन एनीवन इफ यू टेल मी व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ डिले? इजी आंसर इज इजी. नो वन
सर उसका मैकेनिकल स्पीड भी काउंट करना है हमें सर, वो उसके साथ सिंक में नहीं होगा नहीं तो.
यस यस इट इज, दिस इज बिकॉज ऑफ द स्पीड. वी कैन कंट्रोल द स्पीड डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द डिले. Can I put up the relation between the speed and the delay? Delay jada speed. Sir, delay agar jada hai to speed.
Sir kam ho jata hai speed.
Kam hoga, yes. Aur delay agar kam to speed jada. Okay. So remember your delay and your speed is inversely proportional. Delay agar jada to speed kam hoga. Okay. और डिले अगर कम है तो स्पीड आपका ज्यादा होगा. सो दिस इज फॉर दैट वी हैव अ हार्डवेयर इंटरफेसिंग टू शो यू इफ आई एम चेंजिंग द डिले वैल्यू. अगर डिले में बढ़ा रहा हूं तो आपका स्पीड कम होगा. यू विल बी एबल टू सी दिस. ओके सो डिले प्रोग्राम इज यूज्ड हियर सो दैट यू कैन कंट्रोल द स्पीड ऑफ द स्टेपर मोटर डिपेंडिंग अपॉन योर रिक्वायरमेंट, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन योर रिक्वायरमेंट. ओके एंड डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दैट दिस वैल्यू विल बी लोडेड इन टू द रजिस्टर्स. ये हम कुछ भी नहीं वैल्यू पुट अप करेंगे डिपेंडिंग अपॉन. नाउ दिस इज ऑल्सो कैलकुलेशन पार्ट कि मुझे स्पीड आरपीएम क्या कितना चाहिए. डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दैट यू विल हैव द वैल्यू विच हैज टू बी लोडेड इन R5 एंड R7. ओके सो फॉर टाइमिंग जस्ट रिमेम्बर अगर मुझे स्पीड कम चाहिए तो डिले बढ़ाओ, और मुझे स्पीड अगर ज्यादा चाहिए तो डिले को कम कर दो. बस दैट इज हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू कंट्रोल द स्पीड ऑफ द स्टेपर मोटर. इज इट क्लियर टू एवरीवन? Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So actually, हमको hardware interfacing है stepper motor का. तो उस time पे मैं आपको बता सकता हूँ. But पता नहीं मुझे whether हम ये hardware part करेंगे या नहीं करेंगे. But you will be able to understand कि delay का function क्या है in the programming of stepper motor. Okay. Now we will go to the next logic now.
So.
हाँ बोलो.
सर एक डाउट है सर ये लेकिन सर 8051 जो है सर ये हमेशा सर ये लो स्पीड मोटर्स को इंटरफेस हम नहीं कर सकते ना सर, बिकॉज लो स्पीड मोटर्स में जिसका आरपीएम कम है सर उसमें डिले ज्यादा लगेगा, लेकिन सर हम लोगों के पास तो लिमिटेड मेमोरी रहेगा तो सर जो काउंट हम स्टोर करेंगे वो लिमिटेड रहेगा डिले के लिए तो सर हम लोग.
नहीं नहीं इट इज नॉट द केस. इट इज नॉट द केस. नाउ हियर द प्रोग्राम व्हिच यू आर एबल टू सी. Now in this case they have put up FF value in R5 and FF value in R7. Okay. अगर मुझे चाहिए कि मैं एक ही रजिस्टर लू और FF को पुट अप करूँ और उसको डिक्रीमेंट करूँ जब तक वो जीरो नहीं होता है तो दैट केस ऑल्सो आई कैन यूज. ओके या भी उन्होंने दो रजिस्टर यूज किए. आई कैन गो विद वन रजिस्टर ऑल्सो. सो दैट इज ऑल पार्ट ऑफ वॉट हाउ मच स्पीड यू हैव टू कंट्रोल. ओके बट स्पीड ओनली कैन बी कंट्रोल्ड बिकॉज आप जो कोड भेज रहे हो कोड का सिर्फ यही काम है कि वो पर्टिकुलर वाइंडिंग्स को ऑन करेगा और बाकी पर्टिकुलर वाइंडिंग्स को ऑफ करेगा जो मैंने आपको पहले बताया. ओके और वो हिसाब से अगर आप करंट फ्लो कर रहे हो वाइंडिंग से तो आपका रोटर वो डायरेक्शन में जाएगा, लेकिन वो डायरेक्शन से दूसरे डायरेक्शन में जाने को कितना टाइम लगना चाहिए दैट ऑल डिपेंड्स अपॉन योर डिले. क्योंकि आपको पता है इफ यू सी इन द प्रोग्राम दो कोड के बीच में मैंने डिले डाला है. कैन यू सी हियर? दो कोड के बीच में मैंने डिले डाला है. ये कोड के दोनों बीच में एक डिले डाला है. इसके बीच में मैंने एक डिले डाला. इसके बीच में मैंने एक डिले डाला. तो मैं कोड भेज रहा हूं लेकिन कितने देर के बाद दूसरा कोड आ रहा है That is how actually you are controlling the speed of the rotor, of the stepper motor. Do you understand this? So this is how, the depending upon of the speed, you will be calculating what value has to be loaded into the resistor, and you have to wait till that value. Okay, then the next code will go. तब तक आपका वो रोटर मोटर सॉरी ये जो रोटर है तब तक वही पोजीशन में रहेगा बट इट इज सो फास्ट दैट यू वोंट बी एबल टू सी द स्पीड लेकिन अगर हम डिले डिले बहुत ही ज्यादा बढ़ा रहे हैं देन एक्चुअली हम देख सकते हैं कि स्पीड एक्चुअली कम हो गई डिले अगर हम बहुत ज्यादा ही बढ़ा रहे हैं तो हम एक्चुअली वी कैन सी थ्रू आवर आईज यस स्पीड कम हुई ओके सो ओनली वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट डिले एंड योर स्पीड आर इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल That is what I want to say. Is it clear?
Okay, sir. Yes.
Okay. Now we will go to the next logic. That is also important. See, this is my duty to explain you the different logics. क्योंकि बाकी के जो logics समझ में आएंगे तभी आपको समझ में आएगा. The next logic is very, you know, that is very eye-opening because you'll be actually able to see that yes, this is also the way in which the code can be sent. Okay. So please, I want everyone to pay attention. ये भी important है, so you should know this. Yes, this is a program. I want everyone. देखो मैं ना बोलूँगा नहीं हर time. You can take the pic and then you can write it down. It's better you take the pic and afterwards while understanding you write it down. Whenever you have free time, that will give you better understanding and you can also try to analyze the thing. Okay. Now here this is the algorithm and this is the small program. Can you compare the previous program with this program? You will be able to see that this program is really short as compared with the previous program, and the logic is very you will really appreciate the logic behind this. Okay, and as already I have told you, there are n number of ways in which a given problem can be written in a program form. Okay, the best one is the one which will be consuming less number of instructions. The best one will be the one which will be using minimum number of instructions. Now compare with the previous program, this one is the really good one because it is having minimum number of instructions. And you know, if I am using minimum number of instructions, if I want to use the minimum number of instructions, your logic should be so much strong enough. Aapka logic bahut strong hona chahiye. Okay. It should support the. It should give the solution to that particular problem. Okay. Now we will see the. You will see the first algorithm and see the algorithm now. Now the first algorithm is load initial value say 66H into P1. Okay. Now this is also for normal four step. Okay. Normal four step. Load initial value say 66H into P1. Call delay. Rotate the initial value right. For anti-clockwise rotate left, okay. Rotate the initial value right. अगर मुझे clockwise rotate, if I want my rotor should rotate into the clockwise direction, then you have to rotate the initial value right. This initial value you have to rotate right. So 66 will be rotated right. So it is RR, rotate right. Okay. What is the fourth one? Repeat from step two. Again, you call delay. Again, rotate the initial value right. Okay. Now this is the case for clockwise direction. For anti-clockwise direction, if I'm taking the 66 as the initial value, this 66 should be rotated left. So it is rotate left. RL. It is rotated left. Okay. So this is for anti-clockwise and this is for clockwise. Okay.
Sir, हमें पूरा 6390 मिल रहा है अगर हम rotate करते हैं तो हम लोगों first four bits of volt में sir.
हाँ तो मैं वही आपको समझा रहा हूँ अभी। अगर क्लॉकवाइज रोटेट करना है तो 66 को आपको राइट रोटेट करना है, ओके। और एंटी क्लॉकवाइज रोटेट करना है तो 66 विल बी रोटेटेड लेफ्ट, ओके। नाउ दिस इज अ स्मॉल स्मॉल यू नो द लॉजिक। अभी इसके पीछे एक्चुअली क्या है देखो अपना। नाउ व्हेन नाउ वी विल टेक क्लॉकवाइज रोटेशन, वी विल टेक क्लॉकवाइज रोटेशन, ओके। एंड वी विल सी द प्रोग्राम नाउ, वी विल सी द प्रोग्राम, द फ्लो ऑफ द प्रोग्राम सी एर नाउ। ओ आर जी वो सब छोड़ दो, डायरेक्टली वी गो टू द मूव प्रोग्राम, मूव ए कॉमा 66H। तो मैंने 66 को ए में मूव कर दिया। सो इनिशियल स्टेप सिक्वेंस, ओके, इनिशियल स्टेप सिक्वेंस, देन मूव ए इंटू पी वन। अब डायरेक्टली मैं पी वन में 66 भी ले सकता हूँ, यस इट इज अप टू यू, यू कैन टेक डायरेक्टली 66 इंटू पी वन, ओके। सो आउटपुट ऑन पी वन फॉर मोटर टू रोटेट। नाउ आर आर ए, आर आर ए दिस इज अ सिंटैक्स। नाउ व्हाट इज आर आर, रोटेट राइट, रोटेट राइट, ये देखो आर आर, रोटेट राइट, बिकॉज आई वॉन्ट टू रोटेट द मोटर इन क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन। सो आर आर ए, रोटेट क्लॉकवाइज, यूज आर एल ए फॉर एंटी क्लॉकवाइज। यहाँ पे आई विल बी यूजिंग आर एल फॉर एंटी क्लॉकवाइज। नाउ व्हेन आई एम यूजिंग आर आर, कैन एनी वन ऑफ यू टेल मी रोटेट राइट क्या करता है? एनी वन ऑफ यू प्लीज टेल मी व्हाट इज रोटेट राइट?
सर एम एल,
साहब साहब आप मत बताओ, लेट अदर्स शुड गिव मी आंसर। बाकी वाले लोग बताओ फटाफट। जल्दी बताओ, आर आर इंस्ट्रक्शन है ये, आर आर 54 स्टूडेंट्स आर देयर।
सो इट रोटेट्स द बिट्स इन द एक्युमुलेटर वन पोजीशन टू द राइट।
हाँ ओके, टेल मी वेदर इट इज विद द थ्रू द कैरी और विदाउट कैरी।
सर विदाउट कैरी, आर आर सी इज विद।
हाँ एंड विद कैरी व्हाट इंस्ट्रक्शन यू हैव?
आर आर सी,
वेरी गुड वेरी गुड, ओके। नाउ सी हियर इट इज आर आर। नाउ इफ यू स्प्लिट दिस, इफ यू स्प्लिट दिस इन, if you split this 66, okay, so the representation of this will be 0110, and for this it will be 0110. Now I have to rotate this one shift towards the right. One shift towards the right means this zero will be moved into the MSB, will be moved into the MSB. Now see what is going to happen. So one will come here, so can I say the new bits which are formed will be 1 1 0 0 1 1 0. Now this zero will go to the MSB part. Now this becomes zero. Now what is this 0011 and what is this 0011? What is this 0011?
Sir, 33H.
33H. 33H. Now if you see the table, now if you see the table, clockwise के लिए 6 के बाद क्या आना चाहिए? The table जो मैंने बताया था सबसे पहले. For clockwise rotation, the code
feature clockwise के लिए 6 के बाद 3 आना चाहिए, फिर उसके बाद 9 आना चाहिए, फिर C.
हाँ, बराबर है। अभी 3-3 आया आपका। Now how many you tell me you are using port 2? If I'm using port 2, out of this port 2, how many ports, how many bits, how many ports we are using? आपको पता है port अगर 2 मैं use कर रहा हूँ तो you have port
4 bits.
हाँ, सिर्फ 4 bits use करूँगा ना, because you know that if I'm using port 2, it will be P2.0, P2.1, P2.3 and 2, yes, ये चार ही लोग यूज करूंगा। बाकी वाले जो पोर्ट है P2.4, 2.5, 2.6 and 2.7, that thing I am not going to use. Okay, so you assume that your first 4 bits, your first 4 bits will be actually used for P2.0 से लेके P2.3. और बाकी के जो ये बिट्स है ना अपर निबल, दे आर इवन दो दे आर यूज, बट दे आर यूज फॉर रोटेशन टू गिव यू द यूनिक कोड। सो आई एम इंटरेस्टेड ओनली दिस 6, आई एम इंटरेस्टेड ओनली फॉर दिस 3। नाउ टेल मी अगेन आई एम रोटेटिंग राइट, सो अगेन आई एम रोटेटिंग राइट, तो दिस 1 विल बी गोइंग इन टू द MSB। सो कैन आई टेक द कोड विच विल बी फॉर्म एज विल बी 1001 वन जीरो जीरो और ये वन फिर से आएगा तो इट विल गो हियर. टेल मी व्हाट इज दिस अपर निबल एंड द लोअर निबल.
नाइन नाइन
यस इट इज नाइन एंड इट इज नाइन. आई एम इंटरेस्टेड ओनली इन दिस नाइन. सो फर्स्ट आई एम इंटरेस्टेड इन सिक्स. आई एम इंटरेस्टेड इन दिस थ्री. आई एम इंटरेस्टेड इन नाइन. सो कैन आई से आई एम गेटिंग दिस सिक्स, देन आई एम गेटिंग दिस थ्री एंड देन आई एम गेटिंग दिस नाइन. Now again you rotate this this particular bits which are formed, again rotate to the right. Then again this one will go to the MSB. Then again you will have what particular bit? It will be 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. And this bit will go, LSB will go to the MSB. Then again you have 1. So what is this 1, 1, 0, 0? And what is this 1, 1, 0, 0?
So CCH.
This is CCH, yes. Again, I am interested in this C because this lower nibble will actually be associated with P2.0, P2.1, P2.2 and this P2.3 because ye charo ke chari to main use kar raha hunga na mere program mein. Okay, so these codes 6, 3, 9 and C is the codes which I am interested. Now, can you see, can you appreciate this logic? Okay, as compared to the previous one. In the previous one, the number of lines were more. Now here we have reduced the number of lines by using this simple logic. And the same thing, if you want to rotate in this anti-clockwise direction, if I have started with 6, 6, the next will come C, then comes N, then comes 3. You can try this. You can try this. Okay? You have to only rotate towards the left. So whenever you are rotating towards the left, the thing is that your MSB will go to LSB. Then when you change this, you will get FF. You will get CC, and I'm interested in this, and this will continue. So the important thing is that come back to the algorithm. The important thing is that what initial value you are loading. I can take 66, I can take 33, I can take 99, I can take CC. Do you agree with this? I can take any number. I can take 66, I can take 33. I can take 99, I can take CC. Do you agree with this initial value? Yes or no?
Yes.
I can take any initial value. Sirf kaam hai aapko clockwise mein rotate karna hai, to aapko RR instruction use karna. Aapko RR instruction use karna. Okay? So come back to this particular program now.
Sir,
come back.
Haan. Sir, lekin hume position of rotor initialize karna padega na. Because sir, hum log agar इनिशियली उसको नॉर्थ एंड साउथ पोल वर्टिकल रख रहे हैं तो सर हमको एडी को वन करना पड़ेगा और बीसी को जीरो, तो सर फिर हमको एक ही सीक्वेंस से स्टार्ट करना पड़ेगा.
हाँ हाँ, मुझे बताने का ये था, मुझे द इंटेंशन वाज टू टेल यू दैट दिस इनिशियल वैल्यू यू कैन टेक एनीथिंग डिपेंडिंग अपॉन आपका पहला रोटर का पोजिशन कहाँ है. दैट इज ऑब्वियस कि आपका पहला इनिशियल रोटर का पोजिशन क्या है, वो इनिशियल पोजिशन को देख के हम इनिशियल वैल्यू पुट अप करेंगे. बट मेरा इंटेंशन ये था कि इनिशियल वैल्यू कैन बी टेकन अदर देन 66, यू कैन टेक एनी अदर थिंग, बट दैट डिपेंड्स अपॉन कि आपका इनिशियल रोटर का पोजीशन कहाँ पे. बराबर है?
यस सर.
ओके ओके, नाउ दैट इज राइट. नाउ सी हियर, कम बैक टू दिस. नाउ सो यू हैव रोटेटेड आरए, नाउ यू हैव गॉट न्यू कोड. अभी 66 था, मुझे क्या मिला? 33 मिला. मुझे 33 मिला. 33 मिलने के बाद क्या किया मैंने? फिर से डीले को बुलाया. डीले को बुलाने के बाद एसजेएम नेक्स्ट, फिर मैं जो मेरा 33 है वो मैंने P1 पे पुट अप किया. ओके, बाद में फिर से मैंने उसको आर रोटेट किया. मेरा 33 का भी क्या मुझे मिलेगा? मुझे मिलेगा 99. बाद में कॉल को बुलाऊंगा, फिर से जंप करूंगा, फिर 99 का फिर से हो जाएगा सीसी. दिस विल कंटिन्यू एंड दिस इज योर डीले प्रोग्राम. ओके, तो क्या है डीले सब रूटीन? चेंज आर टू वैल्यू फॉर स्पीड वेरिएशन. जो मैंने बोला था ना, आर टू वैल्यू यू कैन टेक. नाउ दे हैव टेकन 10, यू कैन टेक एनी वैल्यू. दिस इज जस्ट टू शो यू दैट देयर आई कैन इंट्रोड्यूस द स्पीड वेरिएशन बाय हैविंग द चेंज इन द वैल्यू ऑफ द नंबर विच विल बी लोडेड इन टू आर टू. इज इट क्लियर ना? इज इट क्लियर ना? दिस प्रोग्राम ऑल्सो यू कैन राइट और द वन विच द वहां पे तो आपके पास पूरा क्लियर कट आपके पास ये है. कोड्स वहां पे, सो देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम. इज इट क्लियर टू एवरीवन?
यस सर.
एनी क्वेश्चंस, एनी डाउट प्लीज हो तो पूछो. I am spending much of the time to explain you the logic program. Okay, now write down the heading. Now this is how we are going to end with the stepper motor. Abhi class wala kar rahe the relay. Relay hone ke baad URT you can do by yourself. And in the next lecture I will be starting with the new module that is ARM 7. I will be starting with the new module that is your ARM 7. So write down the heading as ek baar ke relay, interfacing with relay. Write down fast. Interfacing with relay. Yes, pay attention now. Now relay is very simple. Yes, see here now. Now what do you mean by actually relay? Why we are using the relay? Now relay is actually the small switch. Okay, relay is a small electrical switch. Now that is controlled by a small current, or you can say it is controlled by a small voltage. Okay, and they are mostly used to control the loads which are connected to the relay. Okay, main by using the relay I can turn on the load or I can turn off the load which is connected with the relay. Okay, so you have to imagine that towards the you have a relay in between. Towards the left side you have a microcontroller 8051, and towards the right side of the relay you have the load jisko mujhe control karna hai. कंट्रोल करना है बोले तो उसको ऑन या फिर ऑफ करना है. ओके, ऑन या फिर ऑफ करना है. तो व्हाई डू वी यूज द रिले? हम डायरेक्टली क्यों नहीं कनेक्ट कर सकते लोड को? द ओनली थिंग इज दैट समटाइम्स इट मेड हैपन दैट बिकॉज ऑफ माल फंक्शनिंग द लोड मे बी डैमेज एंड द करंट मे फ्लो टूवर्ड्स द माइक्रो कंट्रोलर एंड दैट मे ऑल्सो डैमेज द माइक्रो कंट्रोलर. सो इन बिटवीन इफ आई प्लेस द रिले, this relay plays an important role. It is like a Kit Kat. क्योंकि कभी कभी घर पे भी आपका फ्लो होता है करंट का. ओके, वेन देर इज अ ओवर पावर, ओके, देन यू हैव अ किट कैट विच विल स्विच ऑफ द पावर सप्लाई टू योर हाउस. ओके, तो कभी कभी इन सच सिचुएशन कभी लोड भी हम कभी बढ़ाते हैं. समटाइम्स इफ यू आर यूजिंग हीटर और इफ यू आर यूजिंग वॉशिंग मशीन, समटाइम्स इट मैट हैपन दैट your power supply is getting boost up, and in that case it may damage your load, so that you have a Kit Kat, or that is called as a relay. So वैसा ही है. If I do not want to damage my controlling device or my load, then you better provide a relay. So relay is nothing but it is a switch. Okay, so वैसे देखा जाए तो relay are mostly used to isolate two systems. Okay, one which is operating, that is a microcontroller, and which is the load. Okay, and this load and your microcontroller will work upon two different VI characteristics. Voltage or current microcontroller ka alag hota hai aur aapka load ka alag hota hai. Okay, to isliye agar load damage ho raha hai, overpower ho raha hai, so that should not damage your microcontroller. So it's better you provide the relay. You can provide a relay. Okay, now there are actually two types of relay, electromechanical relay or you have solid state relay. Okay, so you have EMR, that is called as electromechanical relay, or else you have SSR, that is solid state relay. Okay, so today I'll be talking about only EMR. You can do SSR as a homework. Okay, electromechanical relay, what is the function of this electromechanical relay? Now this electromechanical relay actually consists of electromagnet. Okay, it consists of electromagnet and switch and a spring. Okay, you have electromagnet, you have a switch, and you have a spring. Now when an electromagnet is energized, whenever electromagnet is energized, okay, so you can show the electric magnet in this manner. So when the coil is energized, this will produce an electromagnetic field. Okay, this electromagnetic field which will be generated, that will actually close or open your switch. मैंने क्या बताया था, यू हैव अ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट, देन यू हैव द स्विच एंड देन यू हैव अ स्प्रिंग. सो दिस इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट इज नथिंग बट योर कॉइल. व्हेन दैट इज एनर्जाइज्ड देन इट विल ओपन और इट विल क्लोज द स्विच. इट विल ओपन और क्लोज द स्विच. ओके. एंड दिस स्विच विल बी एक्चुअली होल्ड ओपन और क्लोज बाय द स्प्रिंग. So this is how the mechanical, you know, the structure of a switch in which you have a coil, you have a close and open switch, and this will be held through a coil, through a spring. Okay. So this is how it is done for EMR. And for solid state, it is actually made from the semiconductor. Okay. So I am not going to go with the SSR. I will be going with EMR. Now, as far as EMR is concerned, so we have to also understand there are different types of relays. Okay. Now you can see on your screen also. Now these relays, okay. Now if you see with the first figure is called as SPSTNO. SPSTNO. Single pole, single throw. Normally open. Single pole, single throw. Normally open. Okay. Now you have two input leads. This is two input leads. These input leads in which actually the voltages are applied. When the voltages are applied to the input leads, the current flows through the coil. This is called as a coil. Okay. And when this coil is energized, now before I tell you the operation, then you have two leads, two poles. Okay, you have normally open and this is a common lead. So you have two leads. Okay, these two leads are nothing but output lead, and these two leads are your input leads. Okay, so here two input leads and two output leads. Two output leads are normally open and common. Now when there is no current flowing through the coil, this is how your this is called as a pole. Okay. Now when there is no current flowing through the coil, this is the position of the pole. And whenever you energize or whenever the current flows through the coil, then this switch will be moved towards the normally open. And whatever the load you have connected, in that case, the current will be flow. So this is how the connection of a load will be there. Okay. So jab ye coil ko current flow nahi kar raha hai, you have this open circuit. That means there is no current flowing through the load. Whenever you are giving the voltage to the input side, then there is a current flowing through this particular coil, then this pole will be moved towards NO, then it becomes the complete circuit, and then the current will flow from the load. So here I have shown the load as resistance R, from where the current will be flowing. So this is called a single pole, single throw. Single pole means normally open. This is a single pole. Okay, normally open, single pole. Single pole, single throw. Single throw means there is only one throw towards the normally open. Okay, normally open. Now see in the other case, the second figure. The second figure is called as SPSTNC. This is SPSTNO. This is SPSTNC. Now here the same thing. It is normally connected. Okay, normally closed. Okay. So whenever no current is flowing through the coil, your pole is connected with the normally closed. So whenever there is a resistance or load connected, load is connected, then the current will not flow through this. Now in this particular case, whenever the current flows through the coil, it will be open. That means what I mean to say that the current will flow through the load R whenever the coil is not energized. And when the coil is energized, this pole will be moved towards the move away from the NC. So it becomes open circuit. So no current flows from this. So this is just opposite of this particular figure. Okay. So how do you have to use, depending upon the application, you will be using SPST-NO or you will be using SPST-NC. Normally closed. Okay. Now this is called as a single pole, single throw, normally closed. Now here single pole, double throw. Because in double throw, you will be able to see you have three leads. Common, normally open, and normally closed. Now, in this case, if you are using the load, if you are using the load, that can be the current can flow through this resistance or it cannot flow depending upon your pole which is thrown. Okay, it is single pole, double throw. Single pole, double throw. Whenever the current will flow this particular pole will move towards the normally open. Okay, so depending upon the applications, you can connect the load. Now here, actually, we can connect two loads. We can connect two loads. Okay, a load will be with this NC and the other will be with NO. So depending upon your requirement, you can connect this. Okay, and this is the last one, which is called as a double pole, double throw. Double pole, double throw. Okay, so here you have common lead, and you have the combination of NONC, NONC. So here also I will be able to use for multiple loads. Here also we can use multiple loads. So this is also depends upon your requirement. This is also depends upon your requirement. Okay. So I want everyone to go through this. Usually we have two types of relay, EMR and SSR, electromagnetic relay and solid state relay. In the electromagnetic relay, I have told you, it depends upon how your coils are energized. Okay, then you have in between you have a switch and which is connected to the spring. So this is a function of your EMR. This is a function of your EMR. EMR, and we have four types in EMR. That is the SPST-NO, SPST-NC, SPDT. This is third one is SPDT, single pole double throw. ये सब आपको याद रखना है because हम जब market में जाते हैं shopkeeper को बोलते हैं मुझे रिले चाहिए तो ये सब आपको बताना पड़ता है कि मुझे सिंगल पोल सिंगल थ्रो चाहिए एनओ चाहिए एनसी चाहिए या फिर सिंगल पोल डबल थ्रो चाहिए सो एवरीथिंग यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड ओके तो सिंगल पोल डबल थ्रो एंड दिस इज डीपी डीटी दिस इज डबल पोल डबल थ्रो दिस इज ऑल डिपेंडिंग अपॉन आपका रिक्वायरमेंट क्या है यू विल बी डिपेंडिंग अपॉन योर रिक्वायरमेंट यू विल बी चूजिंग आउट ऑफ दिस फोर इज इट क्लियर टू एवरीवन अभी मुझे सिर्फ एक ही बात बताना है प्रोग्रामिंग सिंपल है प्रोग्रामिंग कैसे सिंपल है सिर्फ मुझे क्या करना है मुझे सिर्फ ये कॉइल को या फिर ये कॉइल को सिर्फ मुझे उसको पावर सप्लाई देना है सो डोंट यू थिंक दैट दिस विल बी कनेक्टेड विद द पोर्ट दिस विल बी कनेक्टेड विद द पोर्ट एंड यू नो the port of the microcontroller and the port of the microcontroller will provide the less current. So the current to drive this particular coil, the current requirement will be more. So if I require a more current, it's better that between the microcontroller and the relay, you have to use driver circuit again. So here also you have to use driver circuit. So this is your microcontroller. This is your relay. The relay to energize your coil, you require more current. That will be not sufficient by the current which is given by the microcontroller through the port. It's better you use the driver circuit, and this driver circuit will drive your relay. So your block diagram will be microcontroller, then you have driver circuit, and then you have relay. Okay, so that thing I will show you on the screen. Just give me two to three minutes. Okay. Just I will wind up this because ये होने के बाद next lecture I can start freshly with the next module. Okay, but there is something more is needed to be explained here. So that thing I will explain, then you can go. Now here see all of you. Here you can use the driver. There are four types of drivers can be used. Transistor driver. So this is a transistor driver. You can use the open collector buffer driver. So this is 7405. You can use ULN. मैंने यू आपको बताया था ULN 2003. So this is your ULN 2003. Or you can use FET driver. You can use FET driver. So this is your FET driver. So this is your relay. This is your relay. This is your relay. This is your relay. This is your microcontroller. This is your microcontroller. This is your microcontroller. This is your micro. So I think your circuit diagram is self-explanatory. Your circuit diagram is self-explanatory. So you have microcontroller connected with the driver. Driver can be a transistor driver, can be open collector buffer or driver. It can be ULN. Directly you can use the ULN. This is a component driver circuit, which is available in the market. Or you can use the FET driver. Okay, and remember these names, which particular things are used. Okay, so this is also self-explanatory. You can use either of these four drivers to drive your relay. Okay, and now comes the last portion only. You can take the peek of this, please. और मैं बता रहा हूँ कि ये सब होने के बाद आप फेयर करते जाओ. And the last one is the example. The last one is the example. This is the example. Relay driving a bulb. Your relay is driving a bulb. Your bulb is connected here. Can I say this is my load? You can say resistance or this is your load. This is your relay. I am using the transistor. And this is my 8051. See, you have a mini pro. You have a mini project in your syllabus, so you can pick up such type of topics for your mini project. This is simple project in which you have 8051. You have relay. Relay is driving your bulb or fan or motor or any other amplifier. Okay. And relay and a microcontroller is connected with the driver. Out of that four driver, the one which is a driver transistor. There is two and four times two. Okay. And this is a circuit. And this is a circuit. What is this particular relay out of the four relay? Yes, any one of you? It is? What is this particular type of relay out of the four? I have explained you.
Sir, yeah. So first wala shayad hai.
First wala kaise hai? There is a double pole. So it is single pole, double throw. बराबर है. सिंगल पोल डबल थ्रो. डबल थ्रो, डबल थ्रो बोले तो इधर कभी पोल आपका इधर जाता कभी इधर जाता. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड अ डबल थ्रो. दैट इज कॉल्ड अ डबल थ्रो. एंड सिंगल पोल, सिंगल पोल एक ही पोल है, एक ही पोल है. और डबल पोल डबल थ्रो का ये जो है ना, ये फिर से इधर इधर भी आएगा एक, तो जिसमें हम दो अलग अलग लोड कनेक्ट कर सकते. अच्छा, बिफोर आई गो देयर इज वन मोर थिंग. मैं जो आपको बता रहा था, फ्री व्हीलिंग डायोड. सी हियर, फ्री व्हीलिंग डायोड. Freewheeling diode is used so that your transistor should not be reverse biased. Your transistor should not be reverse biased. So this is a freewheeling diode. Please remember the function of freewheeling diode, which will not reverse bias your transistor. Which will not reverse bias your transistor. Okay. So this is a simple application of a relay. Programming मैंने इसलिए बता रहा हूँ कि मुझे सिर्फ क्या चाहिए प्रोग्राम में. मुझे सिर्फ what I want in program, I want just P is equals to 1 आना चाहिए बस, ताकि ये relay काम कर लेते हैं. तो आपको पता है आपको पोर्ट पे वन कैसे लाना है, आपको ये पता है. ओके, सो दैट्स व्हाई आई एम टेकन द प्रोग्राम. डायरेक्टली यू कैन राइट डाउन द प्रोग्राम फॉर दिस एंड अकॉर्डिंग योर एप्लीकेशन यू कैन रन दिस. ओके, एनी क्वेश्चंस यू हैव? आई थिंक परमेश्वरी मैडम हैज टेकन द अटेंडेंस. दोज हू डोंट हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम दे कैन लीव. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू सर.
थैंक यू सर.
इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर आई विल बी टॉकिंग विद योर फ्रेश मॉड्यूल, दैट इज ARM 7 32-bit microcontroller. Remember. Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Hello, sir.
हाँ.
Sir, तुम्ही ते दुसरे वाले सांगितले ना जे आम्हाला करायचं होतं सॉलिड स्टेट रिले.
हाँ
एस एस आर वाले कुठला बुक मे चांगले इफ यू कुड रेकमेंड काय याच्या म्हणणं
एस एस आर ने काम करा बिकॉज आय एम हॅव्हिंग फोर बुक्स एनी ऑफ द फोर बुक्स आय डू नॉट फाइंड दिस एस एस आर एंड मोस्टली द क्वेश्चन्स एंड मोस्टली द क्वेश्चन वोंट बी आस्क्ड बट देन आल्सो यू जस्ट गो थ्रू द एस एस आर यू कैन गूगल सर्च
गूगल सर्च ठीक आहे सर
हां हार्डली कुदर क्वेश्चन विचारले तर दे विल बी जस्ट आस्किंग यू द इंटरफेसिंग ऑफ युअर एस एस आर विथ युअर 805 सो इन दॅट केस यू शुड फक्त तिथे यायला पाहिजे सो बेटर गो विथ द गुगल सर्च
ठीक आहे सर चालेल
ओके हां